Hello student, welcome back to lecture 4 Introduction to Wi-Fi on Internet and Web Technology. So unit 1 of review of network concepts. Now we are going to see Introduction to Wi-Fi. Before going to the lecture, we will see the content of the lecture. So first we will see that Introduction to Wi-Fi and Wi-Fi technology, elements of Wi-Fi network, Wi-Fi topologies, and how a Wi-Fi networks works. Wi-Fi introduction. So Wi-Fi is nothing but it is an alternative network to wired network, so which is commonly used for connecting devices in wireless mode. So this stands for wireless fidelity. It is generic term that refers to the IEEE 802.11 standard for wireless local network. So it connects computers to each other and to the internet and to the wired network. So the Wi-Fi is invented by Ensure Corporation in Netherlands in 1991. So this is one of the simple and cost effective way to connect to internet without need of wires. So it is one of the growing in popularity because of decreasing cost and the freedom it gives to the user. This is one of the advantages of Wi-Fi. And by using this technology, we can change the information between two or more devices. So that should be two possibilities in communication through access point to the client communication and client to client communication. So two communications possibilities, one point to client and client to client communication. So the wireless computer wireless adapter transfer the data into radio signal and that transfer the data into antenna for users. So here the Wi-Fi technology, that is no IEEE 802.11, that is refers to the set of standards. So that define communication of wireless local area networks. So the technology branded to the consumers as Wi-Fi. So that IEEE 802.11 is overseen by the IEEE. So specifically that designed for the local area network and that is MAN standard committee. So that is nothing but IEEE 802 standard committee. So the Wi-Fi always uses the radio technology to transmit and receive the data at a high speed. So there is a different Wi-Fi technologies available. So here the sum of the technology, that is IEEE 802.11a, IEEE 802.11b, IEEE 802.11g, IEEE 802.11n. First, we will see IEEE 802.11a. So 802.11a is an IEEE standard for transmitting data over wireless area network. So it uses 5 GHz frequency band. So that is bandwidth and support data transfer rate of 54 Mbps or 6.75 megabytes per second. So in order for an 802.11a connection to take place, each device on a wireless network must support 802.11a standard. So example, that is nothing but if a base station broadcasts an 802.11a signal, the only computers with Wi-Fi cards that support 802.11a will be able to recognize the base station. So second one is IEEE 802.11b. So 802.11b is one of several Wi-Fi standards. So 802.11b are wireless transmission standards for local area networks. So and it's operate on 2.4 GHz band. So 802.11b Wi-Fi standard provide wireless range of roughly 35 meters indoor and 140 meters outdoor. So it support transfer up to 11 Mbps or 1.375 megabytes per second. Next one is IEEE 802.11G. So this is the specification standard for wireless LAN that offer transmission over a relatively short distance at up to, that is 54 megabits per second. So it is operate at the radio frequencies between 2.4 gigahertz and 2.483 gigahertz. So comparatively, that is 11 Mbps of 802.11b standard. So like 802.11b and 802.11g, that is operating the 2.4 GHz range, and therefore it is compatible with this with it. So another one is IEEE 802.11n. So this is one of the newest of wireless standards. Listen, the network 802.11n. So the goal of the 802.11n standard is to signify increasing throughput in the throughput in both the 2.4 GHz and the 5 GHz frequency range. So the baseline goal of the standard was to reach speeds of 100 Mbps, but given the right condition. So it is estimated to that the 802.11n speeds might reach a staggering 600 Mbps. So in practically its operation seems that 802.11n speed will be much slower. Now we will see 802.11 wireless standards comparison chart. So first one is IEEE standard. So this IEEE standard 802.11a and 802.11b 802.11g 802.11n, then the frequency medium, that is 802.11 2.4 GHz radio frequency, and the speed of this IEEE standard 802.11 1 to 2 Mbps, and the topology can be used, that ad hoc or infrastructure level topology. The transmission range of 20 feet indoor, and access method that is CSMA or CA, that is nothing but carrier sense multiple access with the collision avoidance. So that is carrier sense multiple access with the collision avoidance is nothing but it's a network multiple access method in which carrier sensing is used, but the nodes attempting to avoid collision but beginning transmission only after the channel. So is that sensed to be ideal. So another one, 802.11a. So the frequency or medium is 5 gigahertz, and the speed of this standard up to 54 Mbps, and the topological ad hoc or infrastructure mode can be used, and the range of the transmission 25 to 75 feet indoors, and the range can be affected by the building material. So, and also the access method can be used, that is carrier sense multiple access with a collision avoidance. Next one is 802.11b. The frequency medium can be used at 2.4 gigahertz, and the speed of this standard up to 11 Mbps, and the ad hoc and infrastructure topology can be used, and the transmission range up to 150 indoor range can be affected by the building materials, and the access method CSMA or CA method can be used. Next one, 802.11g, the frequency or medium standard is 2.0 GHz, and the speed of this standard is up to 54 Mbps, and the topology, ad hoc or infrastructure topology can be used, and up to 150 feet indoors range can be transmit, and it can, that is affected by some building materials. And the CSMA or CM access method can be used. And 802.11n, So that is the frequency is 2.4 gigahertz or 5 gigahertz, and up to 600 Mbps speed, and the topology at Gagar infrastructure mode, and the transmission range is 175 plus feet indoor range that can be affected by building materials, and access method that is carrier sense multiple access with the collision avoidance can be used in this wireless standards. So this all the shows that 802.11 wireless standards comparison. So next one of the topic is elements of wireless network. So elements of wireless network, there is a three elements are there. First one is access point, and that is short form AP, Wi-Fi cords and the safe cords. You can see these images, there is access point, there is no Wi-Fi cords, and there is a safe cords in the infrastructure. So we will see that one by one elements of Wi-Fi network. Now we will see that access point. So access point is nothing but wireless LAN transceiver or base station. So that can connect one or more wireless devices simultaneously to the internet. So dear students, you can see these images. There is a router and WAD PC, and there is a more than one WAD PC, and there is a wireless access point, and that from that wireless access point, so there is a two different wireless PCs connector. So the wireless access point, what is that? Is it is a base station. This from this base station, more than one wireless device simultaneously connected to the internet. So this image shows that more than one device simultaneously connected to the internet. So this is the wireless access point. So wireless access point, it is nothing but transceiver or base station that connect one or more wireless device simultaneously to the internet. So next one, elements of Wi-Fi network, that is Wi-Fi cords. This image shows that Wi-Fi cord. So this images, that is 802.11n Wi-Fi cords, that is for the external, that is laptop or laptop, we can use it this one, and this one PC cord, we can use it in the text or computer inside the CPU, we can fix it in the, fix it on the motherboard. So Wi-Fi cords, that is nothing but they accept the wireless signal and relay information. They can be internal or external. So internally we can fix it or externally we can fix it. So this is the internal and the external Wi-Fi cores. So next one, elements of Wi-Fi network, that is safe cords. Safe cords is nothing but it's a firewalls and antivirus software protects networks from uninvited users and keep information secure. See, if you want to secure your information, you have to use some firewalls from your systems, and or you can install some antivirus system in your systems. You can see these images. So there is a invited user can directly transfer the information between the client and server. There is no, that is authorized user can transmit their information between server and client. So there is no block, but no unauthorized user or some other hijacker users, they can't transfer the message or hijack the information from the server. So this is the because of firewall and help of the firewall and antivirus, we are protecting our information and we are keeping our information in secure mode. So next one is one of the important, that is Wi-Fi topologies. So that Wi-Fi topology is nothing but shows that how the computers connect each other when there is no physical connection. So in Wi-Fi topologies always shows that how the computers connect to each other, because of there is no physical connection. So the computer communicate each other using the wireless devices. So there is a two logical wireless topologies. So what are the logical wireless topology? First one is point-to-point topology and access point-based topology. So point-to-point topology is nothing but ad hoc mode, and access point-based topology is infrastructure mode. So first we will see that point-to-point topology, that is ad hoc mode. This is the block structure of point-to-point topology, ad hoc mode, and access point-based topology, that is infrastructure mode topology. We will see that point-to-point topology first. Point-to-point topology. So Wi-Fi products in the ad hoc mode use the point-to-point topology. So these devices connect directly with each other, and they require no access point or other hub like that device to communicate with each other. So although shared internet access does not require that all computers connect to a common wireless gateway. So the point-to-point topology is much less expensive than a star topology. So this is the infrastructure of point-to-point topology. So that is, you can see here, there is a different computers directly connected to the other computer. So the single point that is connected to the other point. So that point-to-point topology, it's sharing the data with the another device. So maybe it is using the Bluetooth, and it's currently much slower than the fast Ethernet networks. This is access point based topology, infrastructure mode, like we can call it a star topology. So this star topology used by Wi-Fi IEEE 802.11 based products, so in the infrastructure mode. Okay, so this reassembled the topology used, that is 10BASE-T, and a fast version of the Ethernet that used a switch or hub. You can see these images. So this is the WAD network backbone. So that is nothing but it's a backbone of wireless network, and there is a two access point. From this access point, that is systems are connected with that access point. So that's what we are calling it as, that is access point based topology, that is infrastructure mode. So there is a infrastructure. From that infrastructure, all the tablet, laptop, and other personal computers can be connected and access the data or transmit the data to the destination. So the access point takes the place of switch because station connect via access point. So, and this method more expensive but permit performance in excess, that is based on the that is 10BASE-T Ethernet, that means 10 Mbps speed that has been added bonus of being easier to manage. So this AP based technology is more expensive, but its performance is very good comparatively other wireless mode network. Now we will see how a Wi-Fi network works. So you can see here there is a globe, which means it's a satellite, and there is a router, and there is a server, and there is a laptop and mobile, and a tab is there. So the tab and the mobile that is laptop, that is user side equipments. So we are getting the information from this through this router and from the server. Okay, and you are transferring the data to this router and to the next devices. So we will see how it's working. So Wi-Fi is a high-speed internet connection and network connection without use of any cables and wires. So the wireless network is operating. There is a some of the elements that some of the elements that are radio signals, antenna, and the router. So the user can transmit the data through the router, and it is converting the signals and using these elements. The data transmit to the destination. So the radio waves are keys which makes the Wi-Fi networking possible. So the computers and the cell phones are ready with the Wi-Fi cards. So the Wi-Fi allow the person in order to get access to web any place in the actual provided area. So the radio signals are transmitted from antennas and a router. That signals are picked up by Wi-Fi receiver. So such as the computers and the cell phones that are ready with the Wi-Fi cards. So whenever the computers receive the signals within the range of 100 and 150 feet for router, it connect the device immediately. So the range of the Wi-Fi is depending on the environment. Maybe it is indoor or outdoor ranges. So the Wi-Fi cards will be ready, read the signals and create the internet connection between user and networks. So the speed of the device using the Wi-Fi connection increases, the computer gets closer to the main source, or speed is decreases, computer gets further away. So many few new laptop, mobile phones have the inbuilt Wi-Fi cards. So the Wi-Fi network connection is creating hotspots in the cities, and the hotspots are the connection point of Wi-Fi network. So it is in the small box that is hardwired into the network. So that is hotspot is the small box that is hardwired into the internet. So there are many Wi-Fi hotspots available in public places like restaurant, airport, and hotels, offices, universities, etc. We will see some of the advantages of this Wi-Fi network. It's not totally free. You can work from any location that you can get a signal. And the setup cost, there is no cabling required. And the flexibility, quick and easy to set up in temporary place or permanent spaces. And scalable, can be expanded with the growth. So and mobile access, can access the network on the move. So anytime you can access at anywhere. So and hotspot, it can make Wi-Fi to access publicly. Maybe it's in the restaurant or railway station or bus stand, anywhere you can access publicly. So there is also some of the disadvantages. So what are the disadvantages? That is, transmission speed is slower than cable. So it is degrade the performance, and there are maybe the security problem even when encryption code is used. So the travel best through the open space, so reduced by maybe that signals that is reduced by walls, glass and water, etc. So the Wi-Fi networks have a very limited range, maybe it is 100 to 150 feet. So there are high chances to get inferences of if wireless network signals start to overlap. So and also the power consumption also it's too high. So, summary of this lecture, hopefully in this presentation you may have learned that what a Wi-Fi technology is and what are the elements of Wi-Fi networks. It is Wi-Fi topology and how Wi-Fi networks works. So these are the reference books which I have prepared, so you can also go through these books and get lot of information from these books. Thank you.